Hi and welcome to another episode of my Small Business Entrepreneur video series. My name is John Edmonds. Today I want to talk about how to sell literally any type of product or service. To a new startup business person with no previous sales experience, it might seem that selling a product or a service is simply a matter of finding clients through whatever marketing and advertising that you do, and then showing them the product or service with a touch of personality thrown in. Some may think that selling is all about personality, and although personality does come into it, there's more to selling than personality. There are basically two ways to sell. There's honest ways and dishonest ways. I'm actually not interested here in showing you anything dishonest, but to show you the kind of ways salespeople put pressures on people to buy things, I just want to tell you a little story. It's a true story, and it happened when I lived in Perth in Western Australia in the 1970s. I remember arriving home in the middle of the day, and there was a fairly elderly salesperson in the house. Actually, he seemed elderly, probably wasn't as old as what I am now. And he was trying to sell a set of 36 encyclopedias to my wife and mother-in-law in the middle of the day. My son, who was around 2 years old at the time, was playing on the floor in the space between them all. This was well before computers and the internet. At one point, he went for a trial close in his sales presentation and asked if we wanted to buy the encyclopedias. And I said, no, we don't. Thank you very much. To be honest, we were emigrants who had only just arrived in Australia at that time. We didn't have much money in the bank in those days and simply couldn't afford to invest in a set of encyclopedias. Besides, we knew many friends with similar sets of encyclopedias, and we knew that many ended up unused and attracting dust. So we figured if we needed encyclopedias, we could probably simply borrow them from friends. Anyway, after I said no, he jumped in fairly aggressively with, "So you obviously don't care about your child's education." Now, in selling, this is what they call the shame close, where the salesperson attempts to make the customer feel guilty and ashamed so that they'll agree to buy. It's a horrific way to sell because it plays on people's emotions and feelings and puts them into a position where they almost feel obligated to buy. But buy not because they wanted the product or service, but because they feel guilty if they don't. And sadly, it works. Anyhow, as soon as he said those words, I asked him to leave. Believe it or not, as he's walking down the driveway, he kept on turning round and saying things like, "You'll regret this, you know, when your child fails their exams later in life," and all sorts of other guilt stuff that's not worth repeating here. Sadly, there's a lot of this type of salesperson around, and notoriously in industry sectors such as car sales, insurance and real estate. There are many dirty tricks in the selling game, which can play on people's feelings and emotions in order to get a sale at all costs, and I don't advocate that you use any of them. If you've ever found yourself being sold something you didn't really want, then you might well have been sold by a shady con trick sales method like the encyclopedia fellow that I've just mentioned. In this video, I'm going to explain what I consider is the very best and the only way to sell any type of product or service. It works. It's honest. It's non-confrontational, it's ethical, and it's 100% directed at the needs and wants of customers. It's a sales technique that I've been trained in when I was in Australia years ago, and a technique that I've used across a wide variety of sectors, industry sectors since then, such as casual clothing at retail, department store environments with over 50,000 products, wholesale, high-tech electronics, emergency glazing, web production, video production, business consultancy, even supermarkets, and a wide range of professional business services. So this technique worked in all of those, and it will work for your business. It's one of the best ways to sell because what you do is present the features, advantages, and benefits of both products and services in a specific way to customers. And I'm going to show you how to do this. I call it the fab way of selling, but it's not fab as in fabulous. Fab in this case stands for features, advantages and benefits. The very first thing you have to do is closely study in fine detail your individual products and services. Now get a sheet of paper and mark out three columns headed features, advantages and benefits. Start with the first column and list every single feature of your product and service. Now this might be 10, 20 or 30 or even more. A feature could be the buttons on a piece of electronic sound equipment. On a t-shirt, the feature could be that it's made of 100% cotton. On a desk lamp, it could be an adjustable fitting. Whatever it is, these are all features, and I'm going to continue with these three examples for the rest of the video. The piece of sound equipment, the t-shirt, and the desk lamp as examples. With your product or service, you need to list as many features as you can. Next, you need to ask yourself, what are the advantages of each of the features? And there will be an advantage, otherwise, why would it be there? The advantage might even be hidden, and you'll see in the t-shirt example in a moment, so you have to put your thinking cap on. With every feature, you have to ask yourself why the manufacturer included it. After all, extra features cost money, so they wouldn't include the feature if it didn't have some sort of advantage. If we take the three items I've just mentioned, the advantage of the buttons on the piece of electronic sound equipment might be to adjust the sounds. The advantage of the t-shirt being 100% cotton is because the cotton breathes. The advantage of the adjustable fitting on the desk lamp is because it allows you to position the light at various angles. Next, you need to go to the benefits column and list what the benefits are of the features and advantages. And the benefits will always, always, always be the human end benefit to the customer. Again, if we take these three items again, in a piece of electronic sound equipment, the human benefit element is being able to fine-tune the sound to your individual ears. In the 100% cotton t-shirt example, the human end benefit is that the 100% cotton breathes so it keeps you cool on a hot day. The end benefit to the adjustable fitting on the lamp is so that you can position the light to your own taste and comfort. Get it? So now we can express all three of these items in three sentences, and notice how each sentence contains the feature, the advantage, and the human end benefit. So here goes. For the electronic sound equipment, you might say something like, there are plenty of buttons so you can adjust the sound levels to your own individual hearing. That's a sentence including feature, advantages, benefit. For the t-shirt, you might say, sir, these t-shirts are 100% cotton, and as you will know, cotton breathes so it keeps you cool on a hot day. For the desk lamp, you might say, madam, if you look closely, there's a special fitting here which allows you to position the lamp in any direction so that you can shine the light in whichever directions it's comfortable for you. And comfortable for you is the end benefit. It's really important to grasp what I'm saying here. It's not as complicated as it sounds. You have to purposely design a range of sentences for each product or service which explain features and advantages which lead the customer to the end benefits, all in one sentence. If you're talking about 10 features, then you'll have to have an armory of 10 sentences, each with a feature, advantage and a benefit. You see, using this method, you can end up with many more end benefits in your products and services which you couldn't have presented in any other way than the way I've just mentioned. What most people do in selling is to simply talk about features and leave the customer to work out what it means to them in terms of an end benefit. If you've ever been confronted with a salesperson who says something like, on this product, they've included a CRS button on the fallback mechanism underneath the BGF platform. And you think to yourself, I haven't a clue what he's talking about. And what does it mean to me? It's the what it means to me bit that's important here. It's the bit that you have to address as a salesperson. You see, you can list the features of products and services until the cows come home, but unless you can translate them into advantages and human end benefits for the customer, then you're actually going nowhere. So that's the FAB technique of selling. It works, and it works on any type of product or service on the planet. Try it. Give it a go. Start composing your chart of features, advantages and benefits today. And you might practice your sentences in front of a mirror to get them sounding as normal as possible, or in front of friends or family and get them to tell you whether what you're saying sounds natural and whether you're getting to the end benefit across to them. In another video, I'm going to discuss closing the sale, which means getting the customer to say yes after you've gone through all the features, advantages and benefits of your product or service. So thank you for watching. I trust you found the information in this video helpful.